Hey everyone, this is a medium-small new Technic set for 2017 called Telehandler, appropriately. It comes with 260 pieces, which is modest for the complexity of this thing. I like how it looks just on first impression, and I'm happy to say that I'm very happy with how it actually performs and how many different things that it does, because as Technic sets get smaller, they tend to become usually less complex and they tend to do less things. Well, this does everything that I could ask it to do, starting with steering, which works on front axle and the rear axle, which is the knob right here on the top of the cab, and that works out very well. Here's what the mechanism looks like from the underside, so two cams on either side, a bunch of linkages, and like I said, it just works. And the place where the knob on the top of the cab comes through is ultimately an axis right here with that axle with the stopper on it. Yeah, that's nice. They then have this boom, which is pretty sturdy. It's a relatively recent piece with a straight linear gear rack going through it. And that actually has a couple of functions built into it. First of all, over on this side where we've got the kind of faux engine, with a little smokestack sticking out there, here's another gear that you can turn externally to activate something that's going to activate a linear actuator. Down in the center, you see the bevel gear pair right there in the middle, and that's just acting against a small linear actuator that raises and lowers the boom on the hull. This will go up pretty far, actually. This is a very nice range of motion. It can bring the bucket all the way down to the ground, and it can keep going up to there. So that's a pretty realistic range. I mean, that's pretty high to take this up. But if you want to go even higher than that, you can, because it will telescope. It is a telehandler, after all, so it should be able to telescope. Back here, you spin this. I'm glad that it doesn't stick out. You know, none of the actuators here really stand out too much from the color scheme. I mean, they have some red pieces used, but red is the, you know, kind of secondary color of the entire build. So this is nice. I'm actually going to bring it back in. I had it extended just a little bit so you can get it nice and compact. And let's see how far out this will go. It has a stopper, actually, to keep it from going too far. And the stopper is in the form of just a three-long axle, this little red one right here. And that will just slide along through. It's kind of acting as a guide right now. And it just keeps going and going and going and going. And right there is where it stops. It uses one of those shorter and wider or thicker worm gears, relatively recently added to the Lego parts inventory. It's I believe, twice the diameter of the previous standard ones. Don't quote me on that. I haven't actually measured it, but it's about what it looks like. There's one of the old style ones right there now that's used for changing the elevation or the angle of the bucket. So that's able to very quickly, even though it's a worm gear, it's able to very quickly move just the way that it's set up. The worm gear is acting against a very small regular gear, round gear, and this is able to dump even from this high angle there. So again, just very practical in how this is designed, you know, to be able to get that far up where the entire boom is angled back. It's really working against any mechanism up here, but they did give it enough range of motion to dump. And on the opposite end of that, of course, you can carry a load like this. You bring it all the way up. This is a nice bucket piece too, with I just like the shape of the teeth on the underside and just how they continued those ridges all the way down. Rather than just going solid with it, they kind of split them up, which saves on plastic, but it also adds to detail and just makes it seem cooler to me personally. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and bring this down. Oops, I was trying to go the wrong way. That was the little safety clutch that's built into the linear actuator to keep it from going too far if it's powered. But I'll bring this all the way down to the ground to show you that even when it's down this far, it's still able to have the bucket leaning back, so it's able to actually hold on to a load. And this thing is sturdy enough to actually be able to take to a sandbox or something, or out into a yard and play with, you know, to actually pick up dirt or sand or something. It's not the most well-advised thing. You will eventually start getting sand into joints and things, and some things may become a little bit roughed up from it, but it's definitely doable. Another thing for play is that this is almost imaginable in minifig scale. Let me see if I have my, yeah, I've got my minifig handy. So, you know, if I just put it next to the tire like that, you know, that clearly looks like the whole machine is at least 50% too large, but bring it up closer to the cab section, and you see that the cab section is a little bit closer to scale with a minifig. I could actually imagine this being adapted up to work with a minifigure. You know, it wouldn't be too much of a stretch. You just see it as a larger thing. The only thing that to me is clearly missing here is a forklift set of forks, you know, attachment for the end of this. These are very frequently used. This type of vehicle is very frequently used with a fork attachment at the end. This is a common use, you know, to actually have a loader style, front loader style bucket, but at least in the States here, I see them more commonly actually with forks and used on construction sites in urban settings to get materials, you know, pallets of materials and plywood and such up to upper floors of structures that are actually being, you know, being built or being added to, or if a large roof is being redone or something like that. But otherwise, you know, they've got all the functionality in this that I could ask for. It looks good. The color scheme is nice. Everything works well. And really no complaints about what's here. Now, this is a two-in-one set, and they include physical instructions for an alternate build. This is supposed to be a tow truck of some sort. And they show you the articulation of it on this back page here. So there's just that same main build picture of it. But, you know, you're able to extend the hook or the harness out the back and raise and lower the boom, which is okay. I think that it just doesn't look great. I think that it looks like a nice racing semi, nice low racing semi to me personally. You know, it's very Spartan in the rear section of the frame. So that really looks like it's designed for performance. And this large wrecker bar just doesn't really work for me. It doesn't really go with the whole theme. I think that it alone would work fine on just a more significant build, but just that there just doesn't do anything for me. Doesn't make sense to me. And that's why I didn't take time to take the whole telehandler apart and make this secondary build. Because I really like the telehandler itself, the main build. You know, this kind of has somewhat of a classic feel to me in how it looks and how well it works. Very modern in its construction and its part usage, but it just ticks all the right boxes and does everything that it tries to do really well. It has the aesthetics, it has the play value, it has the technical mechanisms, it has, you know, interesting build techniques that are very efficient and don't use too many parts. It has some newer pieces as well. Just a lot good going for this main one. It's just my personal opinion, I don't like this so much, but this I couldn't see being improved other than including additional parts, which potentially could have raised the price just a little bit, but, you know, something to give you a fork attachment as well. So that's it for my look at this model, and now it is your turn to share some thoughts about it with myself and the rest of the viewers if you would like to. Comment section is open for you. Appreciate your time. I hope that you've enjoyed this, and I'll talk to you again as soon as I can.